Good afternoon. We're going to start again, guys. Good afternoon. This is great. I'm going to take my mask off for just a second, and I apologize. You can see I've been a little under the weather, but I want to thank everyone for being here with us. My name is Mark Newman. For those of you who don't know me, I'm the university's Executive Vice President for Health Affairs and Chief Executive for UK Healthcare. Welcome to the fifth annual Saha Patient-Centered Care Ceremony. It is truly an honor for me to be celebrating at least partially in person. We would have a much bigger crowd if we could, but I think it is a start. And the neat thing is to be among colleagues and outstanding staff who are going to be recognized as our 2021 award winners. In 2017, the Saha Foundation addressed a need within UK healthcare by creating this award program to bring awareness and recognition to those who provided excellent patient-centered care. This award honors healthcare employees who exhibit a high sense of professionalism and a moral obligation to high-quality care in their day-to-day delivery of patient-centered care. Annually, we select Saha Award winners from among the best of the patient care stories submitted. These individuals represent five designated categories of professional healthcare disciplines. We will be recognizing colleagues from these following areas: ambulatory clinic staff, clinical care nursing, administrative clinical staff support, residents and fellows, and assistant professors. Patient-centered care is vital to ensuring the health and well-being of patients of all ages. Patient-centered care acknowledges that emotional, social, and developmental support are critical to health. The Saha Award for Patient-Centered Care enables us to highlight and recognize individuals within our academic health system who demonstrate great commitment to our patients and are leading the way when it comes to patient care. The judges had a remarkable selection of candidates from which to choose, and thus a tremendous challenge in making the selection. My congratulations to any and every person who was nominated. You all demonstrate our values, inspire your colleagues, and serve as role models and a positive impact for your departments and our entire organization. And to the winners, I hope you know how key you are. You are enhancing UK healthcare by being who you are, and by demonstrating that patient-centered care, what it looks like, and what a difference that it can make in the lives of our patients and our staff. Finally, we want to thank the Saha family for their remarkable generosity. Thanks to them, we were able to draw attention to healthcare staff and providers doing great work in patient-centered care and reward them for setting the standards for us all. This award process is fueled by Dr. Saha and his family's passion and commitment to excellent care, medical research, and everything that's good about healthcare. Now it is time to announce the 2021 Saha Award winners and to celebrate them. And I would like to welcome Dr. Colleen Swartz to the stage.
Hello and good afternoon. Sometimes we lose sight, right? What time of day? What day is it? It's 7 days to Epic Day, but anyway. So I do want to say thank you also to Dr. Saha for allowing us to have this kind of celebration. And I think that one of the things that really strikes me is this isn't like a passing fancy for him. I mean, I've known Dr. Saha for a number of years. We won't count them. But not only is he making this happen, but he walks this talk. I've seen him interact with patients and families for years and years and years. And this is the kind of care he demonstrated, even under stressful conditions sometimes, is that this is the expectation clearly. And he does walk the walk, talk the talk, and clearly believes soundly and firmly and deeply about patient-centered care. So it's really nice to have all that come together. Now we get to celebrate some of you today who have really stepped up. I think we may have had more nominees this year than we've ever had. So that's also encouraging. We have so many people here that just knock it out of the park. So I get to kick it off with the first person. So my name is Colleen Swartz. I'm the Vice President for Hospital Operations for UK Healthcare. And I get to announce the 2021 Clinical Care Nurse Award to Rachel Ward Mitchell. Rachel is a... Dr. Bensalem, oh, you're so excited. I know you do. Rachel is a clinical nurse coordinator in nurse sciences. She's worked with UK Healthcare for 18 years, and I also have had the opportunity. Rachel and I worked very closely together when I helped start the capacity center here. We had lots of conversations about managing this group of patients. She primarily works with epileptic patients. Her passion is focused around education, bridging gaps for patients' management of complex conditions with comprehensive treatment plans. Rachel is a remarkable innovator. She's developed educational curricula for UK healthcare nurses, focusing on epilepsy diagnosis and management, and has continued to present ongoing initiatives around quality and safety for that group of patients. In the realm of clinical service, her work far, far exceeds the standard of excellent patient care and communication with the entire team. This group of patients touches so many areas in our health system, and her communication is extraordinary. She's treated every single person she interacts with respect, compassion. She's a great role model for teamwork. She's helped with streamlining the admission process to our epilepsy monitoring unit, which again, this has grown over time. It's gotten much more complex and the patients are more complex. She goes out of her way, and really out of her way, for these patients. She answers questions, reviews the admission process, really makes them feel comfortable at sometimes what can be a really scary time for them. Her role has been essential, especially during the pandemic, where her involvement has provided ease with patient admission. So yes, during the pandemic, we were taking care of patients with epilepsy, right? And so we still had to provide that level of care each and every day. She's established a yearly Epilepsy Education Day, has created an epilepsy support group for patients and their caretakers or families. She leads this group twice a month and has tirelessly supported and provided comfort for patients and their loved ones. She is so deserving of the recognition for her outstanding patient-centeredness, nursing skills, altruism, and innovation in teaching and clinical research accomplishments. So we're going to welcome Rachel to the stage, and her nominator, Dr. Miriam Bensalem Owen, to receive the award. And congratulations, Rachel.
Thank you so much.
Yes, of course. Bang. Congratulations. Good job. Good job. Thank you, guys. All right. Thanks again. Dr. Benslam Owen wrote those words, but they are all very true and really depict and provide you some insight into Rachel's practice. So thank you, Dr. Benslam Owen, also. I'm turning it over now to Dr. Gwen Moreland. She's next up for the next award.
Hello, everyone. Take my mask off here so you can hear me a little bit better, hopefully. And so I am here to present the Ambulatory Clinic Staff Member category. And so this, let me get to my little point here. I'm elated to announce the 2021 Ambulatory Clinic Staff Member Award to Nicole Rogers, who is a medical assistant in ambulatory medicine. Congratulations, Nicole. Nicole has been a medical assistant with UK Healthcare for 3 years and has spent the majority of her time working with medicine specialties, primarily in hepatitis C and liver. Amber Daly, her nurse manager in ambulatory, nominated Nicole and highlighted that she always makes the patient and family-centered care a top priority while leading the way with her positivity, warmth, and ability to offer constant support and compassion to the successes of the patients. Nicole displays our direct values every day, where she works with a diverse population of patients and works to develop relationships of trust with those we serve. Her skills extend beyond the patient-centered focus, where she has also shown incredible leadership in coaching other medical assistants within the GI unit and other backgrounds in healthcare, which is so important, as we know, because we need more and more medical assistants, and giving back to our people helps people want to stay with us and work with us. So thank you, Nicole. She has improved workflows and has been an active member in streamlining telehealth clinics, very important during COVID, and improving both provider and patient interactions within our departments. She has worked diligently with the GI unit, which is one of our largest divisions and subspecialties, where she trialed various improvement processes until they were right. Our team believes in Nicole, and because of this trust, they follow her lead without hesitation, where she consistently makes changes that provide seamless care to our patients. So I would like to welcome Amber Daly, Dr. Saha, and Nicole Rogers to the stage. I am going to welcome Jennifer Rose to the stage.
Is that alarm for me? Well, hello. My name is Jennifer Rose, and I'm the Chief Administrative Officer at UK Healthcare. I am really excited and thrilled today to announce the 2021 Clinical and Administrative Support Staff Member Award to Sandra, aka Sandy Mills. She is the Clinical Laboratory Manager and Chief Technologist in Laboratory Services. Sandy has worked with UK Healthcare for 29 years, and she has a true... Yes. She has a true passion about the technological advancements in testing that will ultimately provide the best care for our patients. Sandy received 4 nominations for this award. That's the most we've ever seen for one person. She was nominated by Dr. Julie Rebus, Dr. Daryl Jennings, Pamela Lee Miller, and I was actually also one of those nominators as well. Having 4 nominations says a lot about a person and their passion for our healthcare system, and most importantly, patient-centered care. Sandy's an individual that works effortlessly with a diverse mindset by incorporating various skill sets from team members to develop sustainable processes within the department while maintaining a positive outlook and supporting her team. And I can vouch for that. I've rounded in the lab a lot, and Sandy always has a smile on her face and is always welcoming and thankful just for her team and the department. Sandy's provided patient-centered care through providing access to care for our community. Her leadership was vital in COVID testing and results, and this is just one of many demonstrations of her commitment to her department and team to produce results and support the UK healthcare enterprise. Sandy is a silent hero, where her work has contributed to the protection of our patients and the Commonwealth. She's met every logistical demand related to COVID-19 microbiology testing with remarkable leadership, all the while keeping testing results the unconditional priority through this difficult time. Sandy is a person that has demonstrated that our healthcare system and our people were built for times like these, and that we can do hard things together. One of her guiding principles is the patient comes first, so all things that are done are in the name of our patients. Her ability to lead effectively has allowed for the microbiology team to become a family who can overcome obstacles to support our enterprise for every patient, every time. Hard times demand extraordinary effort, and Sandy Mills stepped up to that plate and hit a home run. I'm gonna get emotional. Please welcome to the stage Sandy Mills and one of her many nominators, Pamela Lee Miller, to receive the award. Congratulations. Don't go that way.
Don't fall off.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Congratulations.
I will now welcome Dr. Paula Bailey to the stage.
Okay, I'm a little anxious about this. This is the first time the lower part of my face has been seen in public in a really long time. So I tried to put makeup all over the whole thing, but if it's a little off, y'all know why. it's a skill that you lose. So I am Paula Bailey. I am a hospitalist by trade, but I am here today as the medical director of the Office of Patient Experience to present, I think, a really important award, because as the leaders of the healthcare team, obviously physicians play a great role in setting being the role model and setting the stage. So I'm here today to give the 2021 Assistant Professor Award to Dr. Prakash Pendali. Dr. Pendali is a decorated Army veteran. His multiple tours of combat and military training have prepared him well to practice surgical oncology with military precision. He embodies these values and has for the last 2 decades of his life, and has carried these tenets from his active combat days to the UK College of Medicine and UK Healthcare. Oncology is an emotionally draining field for both patients and healthcare providers, and Dr. Pendali walks with his patients and helps them through their darkest hours. Cancer patients often face very difficult decisions. They often rely on their doctor to help them through this decision-making and lead them toward the best treatment options. Dr. Pendali is an excellent leader and patient advocate. He always helps patients and their families through these most difficult decisions by providing them with the best medical advice and navigating them toward the best treatments. He will always identify the risks and benefits and explain complex medical information to allow the patient to confidently participate in decision making. Every UK surgery team member knows how compassionate and caring Dr. Pendali is toward every patient he encounters. He always incorporates patients and families in every step of the treatment process. The time he invests in new research, building partnerships to improve patient care, and creating a positive environment all the time for our patients and families highlights this leadership. Thank you for all that you do to continue to make things better for every patient, every time. Please welcome to the stage Dr. Prakash Pendali and his nominators, Tamara and Eileen. So I actually get to do two, and I want you guys to know these awards make me so proud of my colleagues and, again, make me just feel privileged that I get to come to work here every day. So finally, I am honored to announce the final and newest category to the Saha Awards, the Resident Fellow Award. And I am happy to announce the 2021 Resident Fellow Award winner is Dr. Ethan Ritter, who is part of the Graduate Medical Education in Internal Medicine and Pediatrics. Ethan is finishing his residency and will continue to care for both adults and children in and outside of UK healthcare. Dr. Ritter always has the patient at the forefront of his focus. He identifies innovative solutions by thinking outside the box in order to meet the needs of his patients. His attention ensures access to care, where he has stepped up in various situations and many times to go above and beyond expectations and to take on additional patients to ensure that they had the care that they needed. His commitment to patient care and his ability to go out of his way to ensure patients receive things like medications. He will hand deliver lab samples to allow for a timely follow-up on results and will always problem solve to the benefit of the patients and their families. Dr. Ritter is dedicated to providing the most effective care daily. As a colleague, he continues to be a leader in educating and coaching his peers on new information. He has been able to navigate through the bureaucracy of the healthcare system with ease to get his patients advanced treatments and medications that they need. His behavior to advocate for patients is proactive and instinctual. He continues to demonstrate compassion through patient care and teamwork by utilizing the network of resources available at our institution, and he always makes sure that it happens. We are very lucky to have Dr. Ritter on our team, and he is someone that is the epitome of a patient-centered advocate who is changing the way we care for our patients and their families. So please welcome to the stage Dr. Ethan Ritter and his nominator, Dr. John Stewart. And now for the closing remarks, I would like to welcome Dr. Sibu Saha to the stage.
Mm-hmm. Hi, my name is Renee Saha. I'm actually the acting president of the Saha Foundation, and Dr. Saha is my dad. So, without getting too emotional, it's been such a long and a heavy year. Excuse me, but it's so good to see everybody's faces. It's been such a while. But the Saha Awards provide wonderful opportunities, we've just heard, for us to bring to light to those quiet and unseen moments that our healthcare professionals dedicated to their, professionals dedicated to their patients. It allows for us to see what each and every one of you do every day. We are deeply moved by the compassion you show to your patients. And it makes us all very proud and of the great work that you do each and every day. Because I know this year and a half has been painful for so many. I want us to give all another round of applause for each and every one of you. You've done such extraordinary work. Our mission, again, is to give outstanding patient-centered care, and you are living that mission in every moment of your days here. We want to extend our gratitude and congratulations to each and every one of you for this special event, and a special thanks to UK Healthcare, which continues to provide excellent service to our community and to our Commonwealth. On behalf of the Saha Foundation, I would like to congratulate all of the awardees of the patient-focused care, and I would like to thank leadership for your support for this awards. And special thanks to Megan, sorry for the emotion, but special thanks to you and your team for all of the efforts to make this possible, even in this small environment. It's been very good to celebrate with you all today. Thank you again. Dad, do you have anything else that you'd like to say? Maybe a little bit more together.
All that emotion comes from our mother, so don't blame me for it. But well said. This is a special occasion, and I don't have to tell you I live in this life, and I'm proud to be a member of this family. UK Healthcare, as you know, every day going forward, and is advancing, and healthcare is a teamwork. It takes every one of us. And like I said, I'm proud to be a member of this family, and thank you all, and I appreciate leaders, what is calling my old friend, excuse me, I should not say their old friend, but friend. But, and it's very difficult, the circumstances, and I cannot say enough, and you all know this, like, how hard it has been over a year. And this healthcare has stood the ground and taking us through. So thanks to the leadership, thanks to all the people you do. Megan, I appreciate you being there, seeing through all this. She works through the year and does all those things. And I said, Miss Lang, where is she? She was the idea behind this. Many years ago, she said, you give money to many different charitable things. I said, well, that's part of my life. She said, why don't you do something? That was our idea, and with a couple of other people, Dr. McClure. But here we are, but it is a good thing. It really is, and I have no doubt in my mind that this organization will continue to push forward. And we are the leader, not only Kentucky, the Commonwealth that he talks about, focusing on the campus, community, and Commonwealth. I think we are nationally known. Thank you again. Thank you all for being here.
All right, as we wrap this up, I'm gonna do the last few little housekeeping things. A special thank you to just the Saha Award Selection Committee. Additionally, like without you, this process wouldn't have been possible. So we thank you for all the time and commitment that you brought to this to make these awards possible today. We'd also like to recognize all the other candidates in each category who are a part of the final selection process. So they're all via Zoom right now. Great work doesn't happen by accident. So
We appreciate everything that you do for UK healthcare. So the different categories that had all of the other nominations, the ambulatory clinic staff, there was Aaliyah Scott, Aaron King, and Michelle Wysoski. Assistant Professor Dr. Ashish Maskey and Dr. Gabby Gabriel. The clinical administrative staff support, Monica Ellis. Clinical care nurse was Donna Dennis and Leslie Hargis. And the resident and fellow category, there was Dr. Alexander Wade, Dr. Neil Tupin, and Dr. Paige Sutton. Final things, due to COVID restrictions, we cannot have a formal reception. However, when you all leave, please visit the front table. I have a special gift for each and every one of you that attended physically here today. If you parked in the garage and you need parking, please come see me at the front stage after this ceremony. And I ask all of the honorees, their families, and their nominators to stay after, and we can do some additional pictures with the photographer. Thank you, everybody, for being here today, both virtually and in person, and have a great afternoon. Thank you.